Nottingham is an executive like many others. He has a well-paying job, a good measure of responsibility, and some restless moments. Ellis is a marketing representative for the Singer Corporation. He designs and sells aeronautical systems. His routine is a familiar one: reports, phone calls, business meetings. One day is very much like the next. But sometimes in the afternoon, the figures blur on the page like they do for many of us, and he daydreams. An Air Force pilot since 1970, Ellis's daydreams are about flying. But no ordinary pilot is he. At least four times a month, he leaves his office for a part-time job that most pilots could only daydream about. Ellis is a captain in the Air National Guard. He flies the F-105 fighter bomber, one of the fastest airplanes in the country.
Today's mission? The weather is the first priority of business day.
A typical mission starts for Ellis 2 hours before flight time, when the pilots are briefed on weather and split-second timing.
The range time at Air Force Dare is 1400 to 1410. So you only have 10 minutes to make one high threat pass.
Speaking of split-second timing, on the day of this mission, one novice jet pilot arrived a little bit late.
Just to give you a general background of the battle situation.
That's right. Ellis and I were a flying team and members of the squad of four aircraft that were going to participate in today's mission. They were fueling at 20,000 feet and a low-level bombing drill.
MRC territory is depicted by this line here.
An imaginary fighting situation was laid out.
In the immediate target area, your threats consist of the SAM site already indicated and a high concentration of anti-aircraft batteries.
The unpopulated ranges of Tennessee were transformed into obscure nations. Today's adversaries are the Democratic Republic of Arrakis and the People's Republic of Caledon. Our squad's objective? Knock out a DPRA command post of reinforced concrete surrounded by anti-aircraft batteries. The Air National Guard is a reserve unit of the United States Air Force, to be called to duty in the event of a disaster or emergency. Even though they do not belong to an active branch of the military, F-105 pilots are required to fly 7 missions per month, as much flying time as their counterparts in the Air Force. Ellis, is this the F-105?
This is the F-105.
This is how we're going to go flying?
That's right. That's right.
How fast does this plane go?
Well, we'll probably see today about 600 nautical miles an hour, which is a little over 600, about 650 maybe, statute miles an hour.
Now, this plane has the unique capability of being able to fly really low, right?
Well, yes, it flies low, and it flies at higher speeds when it flies low. Obviously, the high speed gives us an advantage in that we don't have people taking pot shots at us or something like that, lucky shots.
Pot shots from enemy planes didn't make this novice flyer too secure. And I felt even worse when I climbed into the plane's tiny cockpit. Oh my gosh, this is where I'm going to sit?
Acceleration that you would feel like, for instance, off of an aircraft carrier, because they have a great deal of thrust and the acceleration is very great because they have to attain their takeoff speed in a very short distance. We've got a long runway, and of course, the 105 is an older airplane, and it's built a little bit differently, and it just takes a long time to get it going.
Whoa, hold it there. You don't have to go that close. I soon learned to keep such anxious comments to myself, for F-105s are supposed to fly together for protection. and the group of four planes stayed shoulder to shoulder all the way down to Knoxville, Tennessee for a refueling mission.
Oh my gosh, Elvis, this is unbelievable. He's so close to such a huge airplane.
Okay, we're just about ready to move into the contact position. He's already cleared us in, okay? All right, if you can see it, you can see that we've made contact and we're transferring fuel. And if you can see...
We're taking on fuel right now?
Right. Mm-hmm.
This is fantastic.
I'm not going to be able to do too much talking right now because I'll be trying to stay in.
No, that's okay, Ellis. I'll kind of sit back here and be quiet. This is much too important.
Okay.
From Tennessee, we zoomed over to Dare County Range in North Carolina for a low-level bombing maneuver. The F-105 is designed to fly as low as 200 feet above ground in order to pass under enemy radar. Once a plane nears its destination, it gains altitude just long enough to spot the target and then dives back down to eject the bombs.
We're moving in. Everything looks good. We got about another 5 seconds before we pop. Okay, there we go. Let's go up.
Oh, my God.
Okay, here we go. Rolling over. And there's the target I've got. Okay, bombs away.
Oh, here we go again. Oh, this is the part that makes me not feel so good.
How you feel?
I don't know. A little weak again.
All right, keep breathing the oxygen. I'll try to hold it as steady as I can. It won't make any violent turns. The violent stuff is over now. It wasn't too bad. We pulled about 4 G's on that pull-up.
4 G's, or four times the Earth's gravitational pull, is sort of like having an elephant sit in your lap. And I can tell you, I was never so happy to stand on the good earth again. The only G I wanted to feel was the ground. Amelia Earhart, I'm not. I think in the future I'll leave the jet fighting to Ellis and his pals at the Air National Guard. Henry will be back in just a moment.